Okay, I'm caffeinated. Hi, thank you for having me. Let's get right into it.
Okay, okie dokes. So let us start talking about this case. This should be fairly simple, fairly straightforward. We have two tables, person and address. These are your two tables. The person table has person ID, first name, and last name. The address table has address ID, person ID, city, and state. What I want you to get out of this is first name, last name, city, and state in one SQL query, but regardless if there is an address for each of these people.
All right.
Good luck.
Well, this seems very straightforward, but let's make sure that we don't trip and fall by moving too fast. It looks like we have two tables. We're gonna have to combine them. And the best way to combine these two tables, I'm imagining, is with a join, but it depends on what kind of join we're looking for. Since you said that we need to get each address, regardless of whether there's a person in the person table, one of the first tables, then we need to do a left join, which is different from the default inner join that is taken by default if you don't specify what type of join it is. So a left join takes everything from the first table, the left table, and it doesn't matter if that specific entry is missing from the right table. So let's think about where to join them. Well, it looks like the person table has person ID. That's the primary key. And the foreign key here, person ID, seems to map directly to the person table. So the address and person table have a common key, and then we can join on that. So what it's gonna look like, and let's map this out right here, is that we have this table, and we have this table. And ultimately we want to have a table that has first name, last name, city, and state. So what it's gonna look like here is we're going to take the first name, last name, city, state, and it's going to take the first name, let's say Abby, last name Richards, and that's going to be from the table up here. And then it's going to take the city and state from the table here. So it's going to say like SF, California, right? But this is a case in which the address exists, and the address exists for the person that we're querying for. Now, what if the address does not exist? So let's say Carmen San Diego. We don't have an address for her. So if this was an empty entry, we still want it to show up just as either a null or a missing entry. So this is the kind of table that we're looking for at the end. Okay? So now that we've visualized what we're looking for, let's take a select. And then let's look at the four columns that we want to select. So now we're going to start writing code. The first select statement is going to have first name, last name, city, and state. And then we're going to take it from the first table, person. Let's alias that as P so that we have an easier way to understand which columns are coming from which tables. P, outer, left join. Because we want everything in person table, every single person, first name, last name. It doesn't matter if they exist in the address table. So left join, address, let's alias that to as A, on, And this is where we take the primary key of the person table, person ID, and the foreign key of the address table, person ID. Okay. And now all we need to do is to note that we want first name from the P table, last name from the P table, city from the A table, and state from the A table. So I'm going to get rid of this visualization here so that we can just run this code. Here we go.
That was very well written, very well understood by me.
Thank you for your time.
Peace.